नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स एंड इन वेरियस डोमेन्स रेस्पेक्टिवली। सो फार आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट नाट्यशास्त्र फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द ह्यूमन साइकी, human psychology and I was trying to understand shastras from the scientific point of view as well as philosophical point of view and the spiritual point of view. Let's try getting to the crux of the subject of whole of the shastra as to why it has to be followed. If we really see, it's a sheer coincidence, or I would rather say it's like it might have been prepared that way, don't know, but it's more or less talking about the 36 tattvas of the Ishvara Srishti or Purusha aspect of the universal creation as such. The point is, today the dance form, be it classical, be it semi-classical, be it Western classical, be it Western dance, has had the practical implication or the practical application of body, mind and soul, which of late has been recognized by the medical field or the medical fraternity. If I see, to give you an example to this, the pandemic attack which has had happened and is happening and it is going to happen also for quite some time, this is more or less only for someone who is not having that immunity factor. When I say immunity factor depends on various factors and cofactors, existence and coexistence, abiding by the universal laws or not abiding by the universal laws also. The point over here is, most of the cases where deaths have had happened are above 50 or above 60, and they are either suffering from multiple ailments. What is it that one needs to really understand, or the what is the moral, or the what is the summary of this 41 days quarantine aspect over here? Let's try understanding that. Most of the cases, as I told, are above 50 or 50 plus, suffering from various ailments. Now, why do these ailments happen? Why should they be happening? one needs to understand that. Because our body as a whole needs to be put in an order. It has to be like in a systematic way. It has to have a structure. It has to have a scheme. It has to have a discipline, which unfortunately most of us do not really follow. I need to take certain incidents talking about this. The point is, why one needs to have the systematic and schematic and disciplined approach when he or she is living. I, in fact, missed on this for quite some time, maybe like 6 or 10 years. Prior to that, right from my childhood, I have been practicing meditation. I have been doing Surya Namaskaras. I have been doing various kinds of processes which kept my body hale and healthy and kept me in a safer zone. Of late, after doing research in music and dance, what I have understood is that this music concept and dance concept is a base study of kinetic theory, and it makes sure that your body is under control. At the same time, it makes sure that the mind control happens at a subtler way, at a subtler point. In fact, the point is, to the deeper aspect and to the depth of the subject, if we go, whole of the dance, whole of the music is a transcription of Vedas, Upanishads and Puranas. In a way, it creates a kind of environment within your body, within your mind, at a subconscious level or the conscious level, which one needs to understand. The point is, we as individuals or the human beings, we limit our thoughts or we draw lines, which is what is happening when it comes to classical dance or classical music or knowledge or non-professionals. Today, due to this attack, people have started realizing. That's a very good point. Here is where the self-realization point comes into picture, which one needs to understand. The one who is having classical knowledge, classical dance knowledge, who is practicing dance for quite a few decades, and learning music for decades will have that edge over non-performers. Now it's a prime responsibility for the dancing gurus, teachers, and scholars to really look at this matter in the deeper aspect, in a deeper understanding. Even for Western music also. Western music also is a very good field. It has also certain wavelengths. There are certain tunes, definitely, yes, which one needs to really understand. That is one reason why I say you find greatness in yourself. You may get that spark, but you need to go deep inside yourself to find it. Start talking to yourself before doing this, and then at one point you have to stop talking and allow the nature to give you the answers. And search your soul. Search your soul. Here soul means your inner world, the beautiful inner world. How do you understand the beautiful inner world? Don't get to the external world. Whatever external world which you are seeing may be beautiful with beautiful VGR colors or rainbow colors or whatever it is, but that's not the beauty. The beauty is within you. You have to understand that inner beauty to the core. The inner beauty which you see is beyond VGR and rainbow colors. Vibrant. Sorry about that. And once you get that soul, once you search that soul, you get that soul, search your mind. It sends a signal to your mind's subconscious mind and gives you that signal. Search in that. Which is right, which is wrong? What is it is useful for me? Is this what my goal is? Is this pertaining to my aims, aim cast, or the goal cast? Is this what I am aspiring for? Is this the end result that I am looking at? Then it allows the nature allows you to understand and search for the abilities within you. If you can do that or not, it is for you. Understand this. This is a very important point which one needs to understand. Though it's a very strenuous exercise, it needs lot of practice, it needs lot of patience, lot of perseverance. It only comes through practice, years and years of practice. And classical dancer, as I told, who hold the upper hand, these individuals can really get to that point in understanding the abilities, their abilities, what they can do, what they cannot do. And even the musicians, musicologists, scholars, everyone for that matter, have that innate capability who really do it. You will definitely find it, but you need to have that patience and perseverance. For this, just because you want to know and all doesn't really work, right? You need to start your journey. Starting the journey is very important. Journey has to start. It has to move on. Maybe yes, you will have hurdles. Because your body got used to certain kind of inhibitions. You need to understand that. But you need to start your journey, right? Unless and until you start your journey, you would not be able to get to that. There has to be a starting point. For a classical dancer and the musicologists, musicians, both in classical and Western, will have that innate capability. Even for the individuals who are not dancers, you need to understand it. Out of my experience, in my field, wherein I had seen most of the professionals getting stuck at a point. They don't really feel that greatness in themselves. They need to search that. Searching is very important aspect to this. Everyone needs to. This is specifically for the stressed and strained people, strained individuals. They don't understand their abilities, they don't understand their capabilities, and they fail to capture the real ability, that innate abilities, the hidden abilities. They need to pull that out. It comes only through exercise. What is the question that one needs to ask even before getting to that, to start their journey? Who am I? What am I? Where am I going? What am I doing for? What is the end result? What is the end goal? What is my aim? What is it that I will be getting out of this? Point is, this is the question that every individual needs to ask, irrespective of their domains. Specifically for a classical dancer, even for a dancer, when he or she is dancing, what is the end result of it? Because classical dance is nothing but the transcription of Vedas and Upanishads. Natya Shastra is not only for them. It is more or less for everyone. It's a deciphering of the subject and conceptual understanding. Maybe yes, it will take some time to understand. You need to imbibe that innate thinking, which comes by default. And for an individual, it requires practice. who am I, what am I, what is my end goal, what is my end result. However, the pointers from this video is coming to a conclusion that you find the greatness in yourself. First thing. And the second thing, finding the spark within you by getting into the deeper aspect of yourself. And you need to talk to yourself first. What is my goal? What is my end result? Talk to your Atman, which is inside you. And search your soul. Search your mind. Search your abilities. This is easily possible for a classical dancer, because a classical dancer dances to the tunes of the ragas. Ragas are nothing but the stories which are being told in Puranas. Puranas have that story which is nothing but linguistic program. It guides your mind. It instills that confidence in you by giving those positive vibrations into your mind. And for the non-professionals, hearing to the Puranas, hearing to Granthas, hearing to devotional songs creates those vibrations. And singing also helps. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen, this is a very important fact which everyone needs to understand. And one more very important point, before even starting your journey, inner journey, re-engineering of your inner journey, ask a question: who am I, what am I, why am I on this earth? What is my end goal? What is my end result? Am I going in the right direction? Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note, with the above pointers, with one simple question: who am I? What am I? Why am I on this earth? What is my end goal? Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Have a nice day ahead. Shri Gurubhyo Namah. May the Guru's grace be with you.